Welcome.
Yes, good evening.
One, Vlad, we've had six decisive games so far in this final. I don't think we've ever seen a knockout phase with so many decisive games. Are you still sticking to your 55-45 percentage to Magnus?
Yes, I still.
And I still stick to my 50-50.
So the difference is not huge anyway, yeah.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
I would say I it's 50-50, but just because of the name, I give 55%.
Yeah, I understand. Also, yesterday when we discussed, there was this Instagram poll and it said like 82% for Magnus. And then, you know, I'm always saying that I believe thanks to the tournament and the way Wesley has played, 50-50 is more correct. And then I put my hand on my heart. And I felt like, you know, if I'm given two names that you cannot talk, Peter, you just have to pick. You have Magnus and you have Wesley. Whom do you pick? Then, hand on my heart, I also felt like, okay, yeah, I have to pick Magnus because simply the guy almost always wins. But look at this. It's just so close.
And Vlad, and the popular thought was that we were going to see a final between Magnus and Hikaru. I think that was definitely to do with a lot of nostalgia for what we saw in last season of the tour. But the way Wesley has been playing and the way this final has gone, absolutely no doubt that Wesley belongs right here. And it's not going to be easy for Magnus, this one.
Of course, Wesley belongs here. I think that he is... he hasn't realized his potential fully yet. I think that he is really... He can do even better. Okay, he's a very stable top 10 player, but I believe... His talent and his class is already, big enough to be really challenging the Magnus in a serious classical chess. I believe that he really can do it. It's my opinion. And something is missing a little bit, and then he cannot really manage. I don't understand how. He's one of the, to me, a very, in my personal opinion, my assessment is one of the main... main underachiever in top chess nowadays. I believe that he's extremely strong, he has extremely high level of understanding and class and very good knowledge open. So maybe something more, you know, psychological, etc. Maybe that's more more of an explanation, because his chess is really very good, in my opinion. It's really maybe not completely on the level of Magnus, but very, very close. And I think he could. So I hope he will manage to overcome a certain problems or whatever you call it. That he can realize his potential, because that's always nice to see when people are realizing their potential. And he's got it. He's got a very big potential, in my opinion. Wesley is an underachiever. His name is not as big as his play. His play is no worse than anyone, basically. Yeah, but so that's why people, they don't know how strong is he. The general public, doesn't know, but we professionals, top professionals, we know, yeah, that he can win any tournament. And that's also why, one of the reasons why both me and Peter, we were assessing this match as almost equal, yeah. Maybe to a big surprise of for many our spectators, yeah, because, Wesley, he knows how to play chess, that's for sure.